se rappelle. Bisous, chapeau.
What's up, guys? Today, I've got something special. You see three MacBooks in front of you right here. If you're wondering why I've got these three, watch my last video because there I explain why I'm getting rid of my MacBook 12 right here. I've had it for a year. It's been great for me, but it's time to upgrade. And I want to give you a comparison of the MacBooks that you can buy right now in 2017. I've got a MacBook 12-inch here. This is a 2015 model. I've got a MacBook Pro with the Touch Bar, which is super cool. And I've got the regular MacBook Pro. This is an entry-level model MacBook Pro. Now, I'm making this video for creators in particular, people who are doing music production or video production. GarageBand and Logic have some Touch Bar functionality, but if you're using Ableton or something else, they really haven't built anything into those into that software. So what can you use it for? And I've got a surprise for you when it comes to that. So watch until the end. So what I'm gonna do is run these three through Ableton. Now I realize not everyone uses Ableton, so I'm gonna run something similar through GarageBand. Also, I don't just do music production, I make these YouTube videos. So I'm also gonna test out Final Cut Pro X. And I'm gonna load in a 4K video. And some of you doubt that you can do 4K on a MacBook 12, but you can. The last few videos I've done, I actually edited all of them 4K video in using the MacBook 12. All right, let's get started. First up, Ableton. All right, first we're just gonna open Ableton Live 9 Suite. Here we go, 1, 2, 3. Wow, that was interesting. All right, the MacBook without Touch Bar was the first up, then the Touch Bar MacBook, and last, kind of expected, was the MacBook 12. All right, next we're gonna load a song. All three are gonna load the same song. Here we go, 1, 2, 3. First up was the MacBook without Touch Bar. Next, we're gonna export a song. This song is 2 minutes and 43 seconds long. Here we go, 1, 2, 3. All right, MacBook with no Touch Bar finishes first. Next up is with the Touch Bar, and finally, oh wow, still working, MacBook 12. All right, I've loaded up one of my songs. And in addition to that, I've loaded up 10 tracks of Ecredit plugins on all three of the laptops and added double reverbs to all of those 10 tracks. So we're gonna see what the CPU usage is like. And here we go, we're gonna play them. 1, 2, 3. Okay, we've got the regular MacBook Pro at about 14% CPU usage. We've got the Touch Bar MacBook Pro at 14 to 15% usage, and very steady on the MacBook 12, we're about at 34, 35 winners. And now in GarageBand, we're doing an export song to disk. Here we go. Similar results, without Touch Bar first, Touch Bar second, and MacBook 12 last. All right, and for the next test, we're going to do the full movie rendering. This is a 3 minute and 34 second movie in 4K, and the race is on. All right, MacBook Pro with Touch Bar is done. The winner is right here. All right. MacBook Pro without Touch Bar is done. All right, the MacBook 12 is finally finished. There it is. Now, that was considerably longer. Let's talk about the Touch Bar. So GarageBand and Logic Pro do make use of the Touch Bar. I don't use either of those applications, but if you are a GarageBand or Logic Pro user, you'll be happy to know that you do have some extra functions there. So I'm super excited about this. I found someone who made a touch bar program for any DAW. So that's any DAW that doesn't already have touch bar functionality built in, you can use this. Now it's limited in what it can do, but it gets a really good start in. It's called Midi Touch Bar, and I'm gonna put a link to it down in the description below so you can download it yourself. It's free. Now there's a lot that you can do with this. You can do some of the obvious things like control the transport, right? Now, that's not a huge deal because you can start and stop with the space bar. Where it gets interesting though is where you can start controlling different things. Now you can assign everything in MIDI. So if you're using Ableton, for example, you can go to the MIDI mapping screen and assign whatever you want to faders, to buttons, to anything that this touch bar application does. I've actually assigned two of the faders to control frequency and resonance on this software instrument. So as it's playing, there's a frequency change. Now I'm gonna solo it so you can hear. And it's adjusting the frequency and resonance as I'm moving my fingers. I've just tried that with this one instrument on the song. Now you couldn't do this before because you just had one mouse pointer to do all that clicking or dragging across Ableton. This is really cool and I was so excited when I found this. I'm still new to using the MacBook Pro with the touch bar. I am gonna be keeping this one and I'm not gonna be keeping the MacBook Pro, the entry level one. This gives me a lot more performance with Final Cut Pro. That's where I was really hurting before. So this is really gonna improve my life. The touch bar does show a lot of potential. I am gonna be using that a lot in Final Cut Pro and a little bit in Ableton as well. And I'll have another video showing you more of the features of what you can do with that touch bar MIDI controller for Ableton in an upcoming video. If you like this video, please hit the like button below and hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. I've got more videos like this with more music production and video production and other cool gadgets coming up, so you don't want to miss out on that. Final Cut Pro X, we're going to... It's called Midi Touch Bar, and I'm going to put a link to... It's called Midi Touch Bar, and I'm going to put it...